Come to me. Come to me.
Come to me.
He's coming.
He is coming.
He is coming to us.
He's coming.
Who is coming to you, my child?
Oh, cool. A new Robert Eggers movie is about to drop. Two tickets, please. No, I don't care what it's about. Two tickets? There is no better unsung filmmaker today than Robert Eggers, with the exception of S. Craig Zahler, who, by the way, recently announced he's in pre-production for, wait for it, The Bookie and The Bruiser. I don't know what the hell that's about, but S. Craig Zahler, dog, can have my ticket money too. Let him do a Blood Meridian miniseries, you bastards! I'm sorry for lashing out. You know how I get with Blood Meridian. But right now, we're here for Eggers. And Eggers is the modern director more closer to Kubrick than anybody else. See, most directors copy Stanley Kubrick's style, typically with his use of the one-point perspective, where all horizontal lines, if extended infinitely, will meet at one point at the center of the frame. That's a vanishing point. And Kubrick had a hard-on for this type of shot. Like this shot of Private Pyle. The vanishing point is the tip of his dick. That's enough examples for now, you get the point. Anyways, most copycat directors manage to get his look down, but never his depth. Not with Eggers, though. From The Witch, to The Lighthouse, to The Northman, there's plenty going on underneath the surface. Maybe the next director closest to Kubrick is Christopher Nolan, but Nolan can get in his own way. And I know some of you aren't going to like hearing this, but it's for your own good. Am I really finding any depth in Dark Knight Rises or Interstellar? Absolutely not. It's about a vampire named Nosferatu, which is based on Dracula. I don't give a shit, I'm seeing it no matter what. So here we are with Nosferatu, remade three times now. The OG 1922 Murnau was masterful. Seriously, if you're looking to get into silent films, this is a top five for sure. We can talk about Birth of a Nation later. Next up is the 1970s version, directed by Werner Herzog, and stars the ever-stoic Klaus Kinski.
Christus, wa? So viel ich weiß, duldsam. Und wenn ihm einer widersprochen hat, dann hat er versucht, ihn zu überzeugen. Hat nicht gesagt, halt deine Schnauze.
Nein, er hat nicht gesagt, halt die Schnauze. Er hat eine Peitsche genommen und hat ihm in die Fresse gehauen.
Also a damn classic in my opinion, and worth your time as soon as Spooktober hits. So when Eggers announced his next movie was Nosferatu, one question kept creeping up on me, like that ghost that follows you down the hallway after you had a shower. Why? What's the point? It was done twice, both classics. What's Eggers going to bring to the third version that we haven't already seen? But in Eggers we trust. And I held back the dark thoughts of the possibility of it sucking. The trailer dropped in theaters only. It was attached to The Bike Riders, which looked like the wild one, but somehow gayer. So I waited for it to leak. It never leaked, until it did leak. On Monday, by the studio. Ever not want to watch something because you built up so much hype in your heart, you feel like it will never live up to your expectations? That's where I was with the Nosferatu trailer, until I wasn't, because I watched it. And holy smokes, this trailer cooked! Easily hands down the most hyped I've been this year about a movie coming out. I don't know how many times I will rewatch Nosferatu, but I have already rewatched this trailer 10 times, and I could go again if you just let me catch my breath. Inject this vampiric gothic shit straight into my veins, shove a plague rat right up my ass, and let's fucking go. Seriously, nothing slaps harder than gothic horror done right, and this damn movie has it in spades. When does it come out? December 25th? Finally, I can celebrate Christmas right with a vampire going chomp-a-chewy-chomp on the innocents. First thing out of church will be let's get this present shit out of the way because we got an 11 o'clock showing. It looks incredible. I mean the whole movie and the look itself. And thank fuck they didn't show us Nosferatu at all. Instead, they let our minds wander while he was in the shadows with his pet black dogs. It's just so damn haunting. Focus Features and Universal, listen to your boy. And don't give the trailer house any shots of Bill Skarsgård as Orlok. We're good. Save it for the theater. I do have to give everyone involved credit for this teaser trailer. This is how it's fucking done. Don't give me the whole story. Fill it with one-liner after one-liner. Just set the tone and mood for us. Nobody knows how to do foreplay anymore. It's always straight to the plowing.
It's mostly that horrible angle that you see in porns, you know, where it's all balls and male ass just...
Not here, baby. Not this trailer. This trailer is lighting candles and putting lily rose petals in the bathtub for us. And it has just enough imagery to keep you intrigued. God, this shot of Orlok's hand over the town is visually striking strictly because of Eggers. Put it in the lesser hands of almost all modern filmmakers and it would have looked cheap, retarded, and riddled with CGI. But honestly though, just by looking at this trailer, if cinematographer Yaron Blansky doesn't get the Oscar for this, I will rage wet the bed. Willem Dafoe as Van Helsing, sorry, Professor Von Franz, is awesome casting. He's already played Orlok in Shadow of the Vampire.
This script girl, I'll eat her later.
So he's gone full circle now, from being Orlok to killing Orlok. Perfect. Are we headed into meta territory? We better not be, or I'll bully myself off of YouTube. Hey, let's nerd out for a moment with the editing. Look at this whip pan match cutting with him running. Watch it again, but slower. This trailer isn't cooking, it's burning the whole neighborhood down, and I got tiki torches to help it. The tone is perfectly set. The time period, the unsettling score that echoes Krzysztof Penderecki, it's all outstanding. Robert Eggers never misses, and I'm not missing Nosferatu. It already won Best Picture of my heart. Well, consider me teased. Let me know in the comments how hyped you are for Nosferatu, and we could giggle together like frightened little schoolgirls. If you enjoyed this video, you go ahead and smash that like button. While you're done doing that, hit the subscribe button. And then, after that, share this with your friends, family, people you hate. Maybe you don't like my content and just want to waste somebody's time. Do it. Share it. Thank you. It is much appreciated. I'm out of here.